Today on my channel, Arts and Gaming with Sophia, we are going to be doing a DIY how to not get your hands dirty when you are trying to make butter slime and you're trying to do it with color, but you put like food dye and it messes up your hands with food dye. So today we're going to learn how to do that. And so I don't know where to put the clay, so we're going to make some slime too. So first, what you're going to do is you're going to grab a piece. I've been playing with it, so it's like a little, it's soft, so you know, like stretchy, the clay. And so what we are going to do is you're going to spread it down like this, the clay. And you're going to grab a permanent marker, any permanent markers. If you were watching our previous video, we did one with the markers too, and chunka dinks. So today we are going to do the same with the Sharpies. We're just gonna like color. We're just like gonna do lines on it. And then like, just mix it all up. Don't get your hands dirty. If you don't really see your color, you can add more. You're doing this DIY because like sometimes when you mix all, like if you're making butter slime and you just like don't know a way to put the color inside of it, so you just decide to put food dye because that's what you see everyone else doing and it works, but you get your hands completely dirty. And so this hack is going to be a Sharpie which absorbs in the clay and doesn't get your hands dirty. You're gonna have to do it a lot, but it's better to have your hands clean than dirty. But if you like your hands to be dirty, then you can go the other way. It's just that if you accidentally touch something, it's gonna ruin everything. Because it's really hard to get off, like tables or something. So, well, you can just like go like that and let it soak some of the paint inside of it. So that's like a little faster. Okay, so I like it this blue. You can't really tell the blue because I didn't put a lot of it. Let me see if these are better. You know what? I'm gonna put some more. Okay. Now to mix. Okay, I like it this blue. this you can hardly tell by the camera, but it's actually pretty blue. Okay, so that's a wig because now my hands are completely clean. Not blue at all. But if you do food dye, your hands will get really dirty. Okay, so now for this sign, what you will need is glue. This, I'm using clear almost glue. A long time ago, I just put red food dye in it in an accident. And now when I put extra glue inside of it, because sometimes I like doing that, because it's easier to take out of the bottle than a big gallon, it got red. So we'll just use it red like that. And we can still make even more color, but, and y'all need a bowl, the glue, your activator, and a mixing utensil. So what you're gonna do first is put your almost glue please subscribe to my channel, give a big thumbs up, and do notifications. Okay. I'm gonna give you some time to subscribe while I go get some cold water, and I'll be right back. Use the time to subscribe. I'm back with some water inside of my bowl. I put very little water, so there's less air bubbles. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna go back and forth very slowly, for you can get the less air bubbles as you can get. And if you want, you can start going around in circles, just very slowly. It will give it more air bubbles really fastly. But if you want, you can just, like, the less faster you go, the best less air bubbles you will get. Next, if you're going to, if you're gonna put food coloring, put it now. Put your activator in, very little at a time. I'm using borax. Okay, so now what is a little sticky, but still not completely down my slide, you can add your glitter in. I'm gonna use this color glitter. And then I'm going to use some chunky glitter, and I'm going to get some, well, it's actually not a little chunky, but it's chunkier than the other one. Some silver. You can do it your way, but when you put your food coloring, you can put your glitter. Anyway, but I did it this way. I'm starting to go a little fast because it's like coming together already, but you guys still go slow. If you really don't care if it has air bubbles, you can go fast, but if you let it have air bubbles, remember you can still let it rest for a while and it will turn clear. But since I'm putting clay inside, you know, it won't really matter because it's going to turn white. And so the air bubbles won't really notice. It should start looking like this, like turning into slime. Start clumping up, all the corners of the slime start getting up. Should look like that. Then when you think, when it starts getting off your utensil to mix, and you think it looks ready, you can go inside with your hands. A trick, if you just poke with one finger, it will come and it's still sticky, then don't keep adding your whole entire hand in it because that will just get it more messy. And then tomorrow I will be doing a gaming. Tomorrow I might be doing a gaming for sure. And then tomorrow we are going to be doing keychains. So the keychains takes a long process to make because I have to dry, you know that. And then maybe if there's extra stuff to make, we can make earrings. Or I might do that in another video. Yeah, in another video. But when it starts, when you go in with your hands and it's not sticky, it should look like this when you squish it. Your hands are still clean. Okay, so then you can put that to the side. And I'm gonna put it in the bowl for right now, but I'm gonna use some you guys might know me from a different channel I had. I'm not on that channel anymore, so. That channel's pretty old. Okay. Oh, and the clay I was using, I forgot to tell you guys, it's called Model Magic Crayola. They come in bags, boxes, all that stuff. So, it's really fun to play with. I was going to do a DIY with a keychain with a mold like that. We couldn't do it because the model magic clay wouldn't dry really good. So we decided not to do it because we did test out model magic clay. It still is there from Christmas, which was like 4 months ago, and it's still not completely dry. So, and this needs to be the project that we were gonna do needed to be completely dry. So if you have tried getting model magic clay to freeze, tell me in the comments down below. And let's get ready. And I'm really thinking that a darker color from your clay, if you put markers, if you put a darker color, I think it would shine more from this one, from this one. So if you do a darker color, I'm pretty sure that would work better, honestly. But it's really pretty color. And then you can start grabbing chunks of your clay, putting it on there, and process to. I think my slime is good for this. It's not sticking to it. Let's see. I guess your slime actually has to be a little sticky before you put your clay in. I'll see about that. If you've tried putting clay inside a slime to make butter slime, then, and did you have to leave your slime sticky to put the clay in, or did you not? Tell me in the comments down below. But I'm just gonna do a quick one, very small one. You guys can still see, but still have a good one. Happy Easter, by the way. Hope you had a happy Easter. It is Easter today. I think when I posted, it's not gonna be Easter because it's actually really late. And I think I can post it today. But it's actually Easter today. So, happy Easter. I'm pretty sure I can post it today. We'll see about that. But right now, I don't know. So, yeah, still have a happy Easter. Okay, I made a very small batch because I didn't have that much left. Looks like jelly. Tell me in the comments down below if I should have a blindfolded slime contest with my sister. It'll be really funny because like she doesn't know how to make slime. She really hates slime. But it would be funny to see how if she fails. But just tell me in the comments down below if you want to see that. Well, okay, it's very late, so I gotta go to bed. Here is the slime. And the actual real slime that we made earlier. It's a little rippy. I'll see if I can fix it, but, well, good night, guys. Bye!